Welcome to IBe Arts. The I says E, the E says A, IBe. I be IBe. I be the storyteller. I be the sculptor. I be an educator. I be a communicator. I be a collaborator. I be IBe, the artist. And I want to introduce you to some of the artwork that I've created here for IBe Arts. This piece of marble is an example of a creation that I made. This tells the story of family. Here's another creation that I'd like to share with you. This is a dwelling. I've created many of these dwellings out of found objects and really strong adhesive, and this also tells a story based upon the slave dwellings from the slave dweller project that I attended. And behind me, Queen Esther is made of a Quaker state can, broken china, and some really strong adhesive. You know, I love a variety of objects coming together to tell a story. So, IBe Arts is not just a place for me to exhibit my work, but it's also a place where other artists can exhibit their work. For example, we currently have a show in place by artist Jeri Hubbard. This show is titled Rise, and it is a variety of structures created out of paper mache. And Jeri Hubbard is the featured artist.
I used to teach the kids how to sculpture, so I can sculpture. And I would look at Augusta Savage and the Catlett, Rebecca Harris, Franz West, and Hugo Rondandin. And I came about doing this because when I was teaching school, this is how the children made their sculptures. I love doing what I was doing when I was doing it. So it makes no difference where they go or where they end up. It was a joy doing these pieces.
Come in. Welcome to IBe Arts. This is my studio. I want to share some art with you today. We're really going to focus on the sculpture work. So we're going to start with a piece that I'm currently working on. This is, her name is Cherry Nation. For this particular one, the hair, I wanted braids. And when I look at the Greek sculptures and the Italian sculptures, they oftentimes would do hair that had more of a European wave to it. And since that's a wave that's not really natural to me, I don't feel inclined to master it. But braids are very common, and so I wanted her to have those braids that my little girls, that my schools oftentimes want their hair to look like. And I think about her and I say, wow, she's like a little Indian girl, you know. So all the black girls are like little Indian girls, all little native girls with their native hair. And I think the hair can be beautiful. And I know that she's looking down at her belly, as most women would when they're carrying a fetus, looking at the different movements of the belly. So I wanted her to be looking somewhat down at that baby, that newborn that she's carrying around, thinking about this new life. So I'm thinking about that in the eyes. I can't just work on one side of the eyes. I have to work on both sides every time because I have to have a sense of balance. One of the things that I've learned is that you don't finish the head before you finish the rest of it. So sometimes I'll work on the face for a while, give her an expression. Sometimes I look at her expression and I say, girl, you need to smile. Or you need a little bit of joy. This is a great time in your life. So then I start to work right there along the insides of her mouth. And so then the chin is down here and you got to have some space for that part right underneath the nose. So the nose is going to get smaller because I have to create that space right there. And then the lips are going to go back a little bit. And underneath that mouth, I'm going to create some space. Now, the truth of the matter is that she's broken. Broken. Yes, she's broken. And the reason is because, you see, I had to glue this back together. I broke her foot. So I was trying to create what I call negative space in here. And this was something that Elizabeth Catlett talks about. I probably didn't need the negative space, but I really wanted it. I hit her so hard in here trying to make that negative space that I broke it here and I broke it here and I broke it there. And there it was in my hand in pieces. And I was like, oh my God, what am I going to do? And I don't know how I'm going to clean that up because it was important to me to save her. You know, she may never be sold because she's broken, but I wanted her to be finished. It's funny because I think about that crack as being kind of like her swimsuit. I'm going to pull those toes down so I can make some nice toenails so she can get her nails polished. You see, I turned it back around. And so that's the negative space. So if I can create that little bit of space and clean it up and she still be standing, she will be a success. So here's a complete sculpture, one of my finished products that I love. And I actually think she could be worked on some more. She could be cleaned up, but I don't want her to be smaller. And she's fine just the way she is. Thank you for visiting me. This is very nice.
If it's magic, then why can't it be everlasting? Like the sun that always shines, like the poet's endless rhyme, like the galaxies in time.
That's Rufus. Yep.
So what's that?
1830, and this is the historic marker. But we're going to put up a IBe Arts marker created by Antarah Crawley. And I like them. This is where the Appomattox meets the James. So it's two rivers that come together.
Where the Appomattox meets the James.
Yeah.
I've been working on a couple things. This is a good one. I haven't really developed a name for it yet, but it's firecrackers in a plaster mold of a 9mm. This is a real gun that I'm debating what to do with. I might do the whole armut thing and just have it as is. This is a concrete one. This one doesn't have a very good texture to it. So got a bunch of trial runs right there. And then that was a wood block of a gun that I had made. This is the only finished piece in that series. No room to breathe. It was this guy. I need to put some more work. I kind of fucked it up. I knocked off his eyebrow. So I have no idea how I'm gonna fix that. But this is coming along. I've yet to really, it's mostly just a figure at the moment. With his hand up, but it's coming along. I'm slowly working on this, just trying to figure out how to carve out some form. And I got this piece that I'm working on. It's pretty much almost done. I'm adding in these little multimedia layers of like old photos and stuff. I'm trying to add another layer to it.
That's one of your finest. I guess you call it a finished piece.
Yeah, this is one of the best finished ones. What else? This is technically a sculpture. It's more of like a composition sculpture. But this is the uncarved block. The poo, if you will. Yeah. This is what I've been working on. My name is Aton Crawley, and this is my studio.
He is painting the temple purity today. I see you out here painting hard.
Yep.
Hot out here, isn't it?
All the better to dry the paint with.
I know that's right.
eBay. I says E, E says A, eBay. Thank you.